Downtown Barnes, Chicago scene in the North Kenwood neighborhood. I'm here with Chrishon. How are you? I got North Kenwood right?
Yes, that is correct.
Right. So real quick, this is the Chicago scene. And Chrishon, you started your own label, your own wine, the whole thing, a true entrepreneurial spirit. And that's why I wanted to come and talk to you, because you are like part of the less than 1% of, what is the name of the name people use in the wine industry?
I am classified as a negociant.
Yes, you can say that much better than I can.
Negociant. So I started in 2013, if you can believe that. Love Corkscrew has taken off to national recognition, over 1 million bottles sold. I am the first African-American woman. The first to ever go national in the entire Midwest.
That is fantastic. Congratulations. And this is the namesake right here,
Love Corkscrew. Yeah, they speak to the consumer. Fun labels. I wanted wines that were different. Again, that really spoke to you. They're double entendres, they're fun, they're great as gifts, and people don't know how to pronounce Chianti, Bordeaux, and Chenin Blanc, and could care less too. So
right,
I wanted
like
something.
To drink it.
That's it, right? That's it. So I wanted to keep it simple.
In keeping it simple, this wasn't what you did for a long time. You were doing something completely different. You kind of fell into this, right?
It fell into me.
All right, explain.
So I started off in marketing, sales and marketing. I was in high-end retail my entire career. The manager, the salesperson sold millions of dollars of high-end clothing. And I said to myself, what makes sense? I love people. I love helping everybody. Mm-hmm. I love just learning about people and interacting. So the wine world fell into me. It was simply me having always that different palette as a young person. And then I owned an art gallery. I always was in the art world as well. Owned an art gallery. Wrote the wine list.
You've already
list.
Had like five lifetimes, by
like
the way.
Literally right there, right?
Right, yeah. So, well done.
Wrote the wine list, won Chicago's Best, and Love Corkscrew fell into me. I wanted to do something that everyone said I could not do. And when somebody tells that to me, I do it. And they're
and
like,
I admire
you don't
that.
Own a vineyard? How in the world are you going to do this? I'm like, watch me. Federally licensed, got everything done on the legal end. I drove to the vineyards, I flew to the vineyards, and I told these millionaire farmers, hey, look, I want to produce my own wine and I bet you I can outsell you. And I have so far. I've literally outsold some of my vineyards times three.
Unbelievable. Yeah. And say the name of the wine industry person again.
I'm a negociant.
Thank you.
Yes.
So that's a little bit more than what people might think in terms of, you know, people go, if they're going to Napa Valley, right? Or Michigan. And from what you just told me, in Illinois, there's vineyards, which I had no idea.
Yes.
We'll get to that in a second. But you go to these places and you think, oh, they just grow the wines or grow the grapes, smash the wines, put it in barrels, and then sell it in the store.
Wrong.
No.
Wrong.
Why don't you explain exactly what you do and how you have that title that you do?
Yes, so I'm actually part of the whole process from harvest. So actually even before harvest, deciding what varietals I'm going to source. So from harvest, we go to the vineyards. I'm sitting there with the winemakers. We are dissecting everything that I want in every bottle of Love Corkscrew, whether it be the residual sugar, where it be how long I decide to age the wines, what barrels, if I use steel or not. So the whole process is all about Love Corkscrew and myself. So by the time it hits the bottle, I'm excited to have my own juice. So those UPCs are mine. That's
right.
My juice.
And the you might have grapes that are grown from California. You said you use
everywhere.
Michigan grapes, but you are the chemist. You're putting it all together, which I had no idea that that's what that was. And I admire that from somebody who didn't even do that before, teaching yourself. And I am a kindred spirit. A lot of people in my life have told me, you can't do that. You can't. What I'm doing right now, people told me I couldn't do.
Yes,
like
sir.
A lot of people. So, but I'm doing it and you're doing this and I admire that. And that's why I love your story. And you are a true entrepreneur because we're in your house. You have been gracious to invite me into this old, beautiful historic building in North Kenwood.
Yes.
You even have your people over here. Hi, everybody. And there's the merch back there, right? Like you're doing this whole thing where we talked earlier, some of the biggest companies in the world started in their garages. So
I mean, literally my home office in the back lit all day from 6 a.m. till 10 p.m. at night. I try to force myself to come out and have a life. Mm-hmm. But everything is here. Yeah, you see the Lampley Reserve, which I just got in from California. And I'm doing everything. I'm doing everything on my own. And obviously I have a great team. The vineyards are working with me and housing a lot of the product in their tanks and such. But Yeah.
And you did the Lampley Reserve is also part of Lampley, the online store where you have other things going on, like challenging the five senses.
Yes.
And then you have certain labels that are devoted to people in your family.
Yeah, so I just created the Lampley line. So think about Love Corkscrew speaking to the consumer. Mm-hmm. I want to track them. Lampley is for me, for my lineage, for my heritage. And people always told me that the Lampley was such a strong last name, very different. And I said, you know what? I want to leave something behind. We always talk about leaving something to pass on. And I knew that was going to be it. So actually, each label of the Lampley has my family members on it. This particular one, my demisec, has my mother.
That is beautiful.
And it means so much to me.
I'm just going
to
get a better look at it here.
Yeah, I'm so excited to launch this line. So these wines will be from all over the world.
Oh,
all
okay.
over the world.
And you're doing the same process where you're developing the right recipe, if you
yes.
will, doing a little chemistry to get the exact taste that you're looking for.
Yes, sir. I actually just got some in from South Africa. So I have two bottles sitting over there from South Africa that I'm going to taste test and see how it ends up being. So fingers crossed that I'll be added to the Lampley line.
True benefit of the work is the taste testing, I imagine, for
yes,
sure.
Yes. Now, this is funny. People always think that's all I'm doing. So that's the sexy side.
But sure.
there's a lot more involved.
The sexy side and then maybe the hard work side over
yeah,
there, right?
Yeah. My guy does not like my living room looking like this, but it just is what it is.
All right, it's paying the bills, right?
You got that right.
So really quick before I finish up with you, I wanted to talk about the areas around the Midwest that you're pulling grapes from. I think a lot of people might have misconceptions about wine from Michigan or even in the Midwest in general, but you have a different viewpoint. Why don't you explain?
I totally do. There's amazing, amazing land here in the Midwest, and it's not just your box wines. It's not just iced wines. Yes, our temperature in this area is not the easiest to work with when mm-hmm. it comes to grape growing, but certain grapes grow in this region that just work for a lot of certain varietals that we just don't pay attention to. I get it. California has amazing wines. We know that. Mm-hmm. We know that's wine central. We know that New Zealand has some beautiful wines as well. Chile, South Africa, but you'll be surprised in Illinois. There are vineyards here. If you just drive west of the city, there's Fox Valley Vineyards. There's amazing, amazing grape growers there. And then when we head to Michigan, you'd think about it. When you're driving to Michigan, it gets 10 degrees warmer as we're heading
yeah.
that way, right?
Just like the ocean, right?
Just like the mm-hmm. ocean. And they have been there forever. There's one that I source from that's been there since the 70s. And they have amazing business, amazing wines. And it's all about, again, just finding what flavor profile you enjoy. Mm-hmm. And there's something that will always be different. Again, my Pinot is number one in Whole Foods. My Cabernet Sauvignon is one of my top sellers. There's some great Michigan wines. My Riesling, straight from Michigan.
Really? Straight from Michigan?
Yes, straight from Michigan. My Riesling, I can't keep on the shelf, head over heels. So there's so many tours. And I'd like to say I was a pioneer in getting people to go to these vineyards, to have tours. And I'm hearing that ever since I've gotten into business a lot more, because I always preach, take care of local.
Absolutely.
Take respect and support local. Drive to Michigan. You're driving an hour and a half out. Go to St. Julian's. Go to all of those great vineyards that you'll pass. You'll see the billboards. They're amazing. Absolutely delicious.
And challenge yourself to get beyond what you think you know about wine. I mean,
yeah.
I think what you were saying about how you decided you wanted to find a different taste profile. And you did that on your own. That is incredible, the fact that you did that on your own. And then we're looking at some of the wines offered here. And you're even doing sparkling wine as a thing coming up online soon as well,
yes,
right?
Yes, sparkling wine. I'll have my demisec, again, from the Lampley line. Mm-hmm. That one is from North Coast, so that is California. Again, my Cabernet Sauvignon is from California, but everything in the middle here is from Michigan. I am deciding that I'm very excited. I have a Sauvignon Blanc that I've created that's coming in from Chile. Mm-hmm. So that's on its way, and I'm going to also start sourcing from Washington. So that's the beauty of being a negociant. I can go to different vineyards from around the entire world and source and create product of my own.
And it's fantastic. And in an industry where it's tough being a woman, African-American, the odds were not for you. And here you are kicking the rear ends of everybody. Congratulations. And for anybody watching this video that might want to do this, then they're looking at you as inspiration. What, any words of advice going forward for somebody who was told no a lot and you said, oh, you can tell me no,
absolutely.
I'm going to show you.
Absolutely. I'm here to break glass ceilings till there's no more to be broken. And what I tell people is you have to do it. You know, we always say, and I think people think of it as cliche of life is too short, but it seriously is. So mm-hmm. if there's something that you want to do, your passion actually follows you. So listen to what you're great at. Listen to what other people are telling you you're great at. That might be that thing. That hobby may actually be a successful business. And every time you hear no's, and trust, I still get no's all the time. I got no yesterday. There's going to be 10 other yeses that are going to make everything better. So keep going.
It has been a pleasure talking with you. And again, thank you for letting me come into your home. I really do appreciate it. For people who want to buy the wine, it's at all the local grocery stores.
Yes.
Can they purchase online too?
Of course, lovecorkscrew.com. Also, when you go on lovecorkscrew.com, there'll be a Google locator there. So stick in your zip code and it'll tell you where to find it. But I support local Binnie's, Mariano's, Whole Foods, Meyer's, Jewel Osco. Everyone has
the whole thing.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So again, she let me into her home and this is what's going on behind me. Hi, everybody. But that is the Chicago scene for today here in North Kenwood.
Yes.
Right? T-B-A-R-N-A-S at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's T-Barnes at WGNTV.com. Thank you very much for joining me. I appreciate it.